Wow, there sure are a lot of Magic the Gathering products and accessories to choose from, and oh, hi! I didn't see you there. You know, for a new player trying to figure out what they need to purchase for their first game of Magic the Gathering, Friday Night Magic, or just to go over and get some good games with a friend, it can often be a really difficult task to weed through all the products that are available. That's why this video is going to present to you the 5 products that every new Magic the Gathering player should look into purchasing. Come on! Oh, I don't want this at all. Please put it back.
5 Magic the Gathering life hacks to buying new products and accessories for new players.
The first product you're going to need are card sleeves. Card sleeves are very important not only because they protect your cards, many of which are worth a lot of money, but they also aid in shuffling those cards, which is an important part of gameplay. There are 2 brands that I recommend. First and foremost are the KMC Hypermats, my personal sleeve of choice for both single sleeving and double sleeving. But also, if you don't plan on double sleeving, there's another brand that I recommend, and that is the Legion Illustrated Double Mats, probably the toughest sleeve on the market today. However, they can't be used effectively for double sleeving at this time.
Hypermats have the best shuffle feel, while the Legion Illustrated Double Mats are the toughest sleeve on the market today.
Now, once you have a Magic the Gathering deck, you're going to need a way to transport that deck, whether it's to your friend's house or down to your local game store for Friday Night Magic. There's 2 that I recommend for new players above all else. The first is the Ultra Pro Satin Tower. Now, the Satin Tower is incredibly affordable, and for many of us, this excellent deck box is the only one that we ever need. If you want to spend just a little bit more money, however, and get a slightly nicer box with a nicer material and build, then you might look for the Ultimate Guard Flip-In Tray, another solid A item that I cannot recommend more.
You can't go wrong with either of these 2 deck boxes. Whether you're looking for a solid budget buy or a fancy premium item, these are currently the top 2 deck boxes on the market today.
You're also going to want somewhere to store your individual cards, your singles of value. Many rares and mythics are worth a lot of money, and some of them are just ones that you'll use frequently or perhaps have a sentimental attachment to. The best place to keep these individual cards, of course, is in a Magic the Gathering portfolio. I recommend the Legion Dragonhide portfolios. These come in a wide variety of colors and sizes and are my number 1 pick for new players to the game.
Available in many sizes, the most common are the 4-pocket and the 9-pocket.
And of course, if a portfolio doesn't interest you, then you can always just get a standard 3-ring binder and fill it with binder sheets. The best binder sheets currently offered are manufactured by Ultra Pro, and they are the Platinum brand binder sheets. Now, of course, you're going to need a clean place upon which to play, and that is why you should always have a playmat on your person. You can look for the Ultra Pro brand playmats, probably the most commonly found at your game store, or if you'd like a little bit more style, a little bit more design, you can look into the playmats available at inkedplaymats.com.
Inked Gaming provides not only the finest quality playmats on the market today, but also features some of the most artistic playmats available. Visit www.inkedgaming.com to browse artists and available playmats. Or if you want to support this channel, you can go to www.tolariancommunitycollege.com, where we proudly offer our logo on Inked Gaming mats.
In no time at all, I assure you, you are going to have an enormous collection of Magic the Gathering singles. Too many to put in a binder or portfolio. These are commons and uncommons and other bulk that you do want to save, but you don't want to put
in those binder sheets. That's where a storage box, preferably from BCW, comes in handy. These come in all sorts of shapes and sizes and are usually relatively affordable at about $1, sometimes less, sometimes a little bit more. Now, a lot of times your local game store isn't going to have these on display. They're going to be unassembled and in the back room, so don't be shy and ask at the front if they have any BCW storage boxes. They are the best way to archive your collection. Be sure to inquire at the counter as to whether or not they carry BCW cardboard storage boxes, as they are often kept disassembled in the back to save space. Also, many local gaming stores may not carry the BCW cardboard storage boxes, but will be able to order them for you. I hope this video has been helpful for you. Be sure to subscribe, like, or comment.
You know, I started playing back in the era of Sphinx's Revelation control. And Sphinx's Revelation gave you a little, like, a lot more wiggle room to make less than optimal decisions. Because Sphinx's Revelation
just gained
was
the life back, whatever.
Was an absurd magic card. It was so great, and especially in that deck, it could cover kind of like a
question.
Suite of ills.
Side note.
Yes.
Is Siege Rhino the new Sphinx's Revelation?
Siege Rhino can go f*** itself.